Hi, I'm Chris from learngrasshopper.com and welcome to the Beam Corner channel. Today, I will continue a series about helpful and worth knowing Grasshopper components. I'm sure that you can recommend some components as well, especially for those who are starting a journey with a Grasshopper, so please feel free to write about your favorite ones in the comments below. Remember, sharing is caring. And now, enjoy the second part of useful components in Grasshopper. Mass addition component you can find in math and operators. In order to show how it works, I will use another component called gene pool. This one generates several sliders placed in one place. While connecting all these values, components will give us two outputs. First one, sum of all numbers, and second one, partial results. The first item will always be the same as the first input item. However, the second one will be the sum of the first and the second. The third one will be the sum of two previous ones and the third one. To visualize that, let's go to an example. Mass addition works perfectly with evaluating length component. Points will be created with the distances between defined values in the gene pool. Member index. Definition of member index is find the occurrences of a specific member in a set. It can be found in set and sets. Example shows my website name explode to indexes. With the member index component, we can check how many times R letter occurs in the name and what position.
To be updated and to learn all the secrets of Grasshopper, join our community. It's easy. Go to learngrasshopper.com, click the join button, write your email address and click the confirmation link in the email you will get from me. You will be getting all the latest videos, learning materials and interesting links about Grasshopper directly to your inbox.
Every Grasshopper user should know the sort list component. This component allows you to make sorting based on the keys values. I will show you the example. So we have many points on our mesh. We are going to sort these points based on the Z coordinates, from the lowest to the highest. Afterwards, we can give indicates of these points. In this way, the lowest point will have the lowest index and the highest point will have the highest index. Random generates a list of pseudo-random numbers. We call it pseudo because they are not random per definition. Connect your domain as a range for random numbers. The second input is the number of elements. SID generates the algorithm how the numbers will be generated. Now you can use these values to Grasshopper operations. Remember that in options of component you can change value to the integers. Value list. The value list stores a collection of values with a corresponding list of labels associated with an equal sign. It is beneficial when you want to have a few options labeled with meaning that can supply specific output values. First, right-click in the value list component and select the option from the menu. Second, double-click the value list component to open the editor and add or change values. 3. In drop-down list mode, click the arrow to select one of the values. The solution will recompute each time you change the value. Next, in checklist mode, click next to each value to check it. The component will output all the values that are checked. Finally, in the value sequence and value cycle modes, click the left and right facing arrows to cycle through the values.
For those who want to learn more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free guide. 20 pages filled with exciting books, practical exercises, and approved tutorials about Grasshopper. In this book, you will find only the necessary knowledge and a list of must-read books and exercises. everyone will find something for themselves. In order to download the guide, please click the link in the description below. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Have a good one.